Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a customer order form in Word. So the first thing we're going to do is to insert a table. So go to Insert, Table, and I'm going to go all the way down to Insert Table. And the number of columns I want is 4, and the number of rows is 22. Oops. And then click OK. As you can see at the moment, my rows are very, very narrow. So I'm just going to select my table, and you can do that by clicking and selecting across the entire table. Or you can just simply go up to this cross inside this square here and click. Then go up to Layout. And then in this section here, you can adjust your height and width of your rows and columns. So I'm going to go to the height of my row. And all I'm going to do is insert one. And then, as you can see, this blue line or blue markers within your table identify the fact that if you start to type now, your text will be at the top of your cell. What you actually want is the text at the middle of the cell and the center of the cell, rather over to the left. So I'm going to select my table again. Go up to Layout. I'm going to go across to this one here. And in fact, I'm going to align everything to the left. So I'm going to click on center left here. The next thing I'm going to do is just take out all of these border lines and just create a guideline. So again, select my table, go to table design, go along to borders, click on the drop down and select no borders. Go back up to borders, click on the drop down and go all the way down to select view grid line. Now, when you click back on your table, you'll see that you've got a dotted line everywhere. It's slightly grayed. That means that's purely a guideline and it won't appear for you to print it out or save it as a PDF. Then what we're going to do is we're going to merge and split these cells so that we come up with the perfect layout for our form. So the first thing I'm going to do is select this whole row, go up to Layout and go to Merge Cells. And in this cell, I'm going to type Customer Info. And then in the next line down, I'm going to type name. Next line down, email. And address. And then over here, I'm going to type in phone for phone number. Now for all of these, I want them to be in the center of the cells. So I'm going to select all of these cells, go to layout, and I'm going to center text. Now I'm going to move some of these lines over. So I'm going to hover my cursor over this line here and you can see it changes to a double-headed arrow. I'm simply going to select that and move it over to the left. Then I'm just going to select this line here and I'm going to select between these two cells. So all I want to do is to just move this cell over like this so I have enough room for the phone number. And then for these two rows here, I'm just going to merge them. So again, layout, merge cells, select these three cells, layout, merge cells. Once I've done this section, I'm going to select it all. Then I'm going to go up to table design. I'm going to go to borders. I'm going to select all borders. You can see I've got one border here or two borders here that have been left out. You can see they're still dotted. So I'm just going to select these two cells, go back and just click on that. You don't need to go to the drop down. Just click on all borders and you'll see those lines appear. Now, if you want to check how this looks, again, select your table, go to borders, deselect view grid lines, click off, and you can see how that will look as part of your customer order form. Now just go back. Borders, view grid lines. Now we're going to leave a space between this first section here and our next section. So what I'm going to do is just merge these cells here, layout, merge cells. Next row down, we're going to merge them again, layout, merge cells. And here I'm going to type order details. And I'm going to place this in the middle. So just make sure your cursor is in this cell. Go to layout and then go to center. Then in this cell here, I shall put description. and then quantity, unit price, and total price. Then once again, I'm just going to select all of those, go to layout, and just center them all. Now, obviously, description, you want far more room for a description than you want quantity. So again, I'm just going to hover my cursor over the relevant lines. Now you can see here, I've only grabbed that one line. So I'm going to click away from that. Try this line. There we go. Now, as we've moved that, you can see we started to move the phone one at the top here. So what I'm going to do is just select all the cells in this particular section and just begin to move over those boundary lines. And then we can move this one all the way over because quantity, we obviously don't want a huge amount of space for quantity. And once I've selected that all again, I'll go to table design and borders and select all borders. Now for this one at the bottom, we're going to put total in here. And again, we're going to center it. So go to layout, center, and center that word there. What we don't want are these borderlines in these two cells here. So sometimes this works and sometimes it doesn't. So if I select those two cells, go to table design, go to borders and select no borders. So you can see what's happened here. It's taken out all of the borders, but it hasn't taken out this borderline at the bottom. So sometimes you just have to play around a little bit just to make it work. So the easiest thing I find is let's just take out the whole of this line here. So select this row here, go up to borders, and you can see top borders selected here. Let's just take out that top border because it's the top border of this row. And then all we need to do is add this line in here and this line in here at the bottom. So select these two cells, go back up to borders and select all borders. And you can see we've now got all borders around here. And then we don't hear, although we are missing this bottom border line here. So again, select those two cells and you can just click all borders and you can see how that looks now. So onto the next section, we'll just leave a gap. So again, select this row, layout, merge cells. And this next section will be the delivery section. So again, we're going to select that row, merge cells, type in delivery. And then in brackets, we're going to select please circle. You don't have to use this technique, but it's just very simple for this particular demonstration. I'm actually going to put that in lowercase. It's not quite so obvious then. And then I'm going to put delivery in bold. So go up to the home tab, select bold. And actually, I'm just going to use this increase font size icon here, just click on that and that just increases the size of that word there. And then on the next row down, we're going to put in shipping, local pickup, local drop off. And then we'll just merge these two cells here. So select them both, go to layout, merge cells. And then because we want all of these cells to be equidistant apart, we want to equalize them across this table, select them all, go to layout, and then go to distribute columns. Then we want to center them, so go up to center text here, or line to center. So for these three cells, we're going to add border lines, so back up to table design. Four borders are already selected, so just click, and you'll add all of those borders there. And again, this row here, select it all, go to layout, merge cells, and then here we'll type payment. And again, please circle. And again, we'll just highlight this, go up to bold, so go to the home tab. Select bold and increase that font size one more time. There we go. And in here, we're going to choose cash in uppercase, check. In the UK, that's how we spell check. Card and PayPal. Once again, we're going to center it all and make sure it's equally spaced. So I go up to table design. So I go up to layout, distribute the columns, and center the text. And again, go to table design, and then borders, and just click on all borders again. Then we're going to take out a row again. So select it, layout, merge cells. And then we're going to place date ordered, and then date order needed. What we're going to do here is, because these are two sort of separate questions, we're going to create an additional cell in here to create a bit of a break. So if I select this cell, go up to layout and split cells, number of columns is 2, and we just want to remain one row, and then just click OK. As you can see, we've created a separate cell, 2 cells there. And what we want to do is to move this over so that we've almost just got a little break between the two questions. And I'm just going to move this over slightly. So for these two cells, we want all borders. Go to table design, all borders. And for this section here, again, all borders. You say we've just left a little space in between. So if we now go to borders and uncheck view grid lines, we can now see how our form is looking. So at the top here, I'm just going to click at the top. To move this table down, you have to click right at the very beginning of your table and hit the return button or return key on your keyboard. And then I'm going to just hit that a few times just to make sure it's as far down as possible. If you need to adjust your margins at the bottom, go over to the rulers. If you can't see the rulers, go to view, check ruler, then go to the ruler at the side here, hover between the white and grey section, click and just drag those margins up and down. So you can create a little bit more space for your form if that's what you need. So we're now just going to put in the title and a little bit of contrast with a shape. So we'll go to insert, shape, and we'll go to the square, and then we're just going to click and drag out rectangle. We're going to go to shape fill, click on the drop down, and select the grey. We're in the shape format tab here. Again, shape outline, we're going to get rid of the outline around the shape, no outline, because they will come as a default. And then all I'm going to do is extend this rectangle out each side and then just drag it down just a little bit from the top of the page. Now we're going to enter some text here. So insert, word art. I'm just going to pick this black one here. Let's move this up to the top. It's going to extend it out to the side here. And extend out to here. Then double click inside, so the cursor's there, select all the text. And if you just click on the edge of the box, the cursor will stop flashing. And it means that you can go up to the Home tab and just click through the fonts that you want to use, and it'll automatically change it for you. So I'm going to select this one here. And then I'm just going to click my font size up to 48. And then I'm going to go to shape format. If shape format doesn't appear, it's because you haven't selected your text. So shape format, I'm going to go to align, click on the drop down, and align to center. So select your text, hold down your command or control key on your keyboard and select the background shape. And then all we're going to do is align all of these. So go to shape format, go to align, align to center, align, align to middle, and that should mean that if I click away, your text is perfectly lined up in the center of your rectangle. Once you've finished that, you can go down to the bottom here and double click, and here you'll see that we've now entered the footer, and here you just place any text that you like. Let's say order form 01. You can also put your logo down the bottom here, you can put your email address, anything you like. But if you find that, let's just double click away from the headers and footers. So double click inside the main area of your document. You see it's greyed out, so it's in the headers and footers. If you don't like the position of the text in your footers, then there's actually a much better way to do it. So let's just double click back inside the footers, get rid of that text. Let's go up and go to insert, text box, draw text box. I'm going to come down the bottom here and just draw out text box. Now, if I click away from this text box, they always come with this black border. So let's just get rid of that. Select the text box, go to shape format, shape outline, click on the drop down and select no outline. If I click away now, you can see that outline has gone. So let's double click inside, my cursor's there, and then type out order 401. Now we can place this absolutely anywhere we like in our header or our footer. So now if I double click back into the main document, you can see that I've placed that right down at the bottom. And you can get quite a lot of information in your footer. So if you wanted to, you could place your website, your email address, your contact details, anything you like just at the bottom here. Once you finish that, you can go up to save. So go to file. You could save it as a template. So click save as template. Now, if you're going to save it as a template for your Word software, you need to ensure it's saved into templates here. And also the file format should be Microsoft Word template. And then obviously you just change the info as you see fit and then just click save. Alternatively, you can go to File, Save As. You can either save it as a document or, of course, you can click on the drop down and save it as a PDF. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.